In Japan, some beekeepers still practice traditional Japanese beekeeping with the native Japanese honeybee. On this channel, we'd like to share some of those techniques with you. This is Mayu, a local beekeeper in Japan. In today's video, she is going to demonstrate how to capture Japanese hornets with a glue sheet. In the wild, Japanese honeybees nest in cavities large enough to build a nest, such as the space in a hollow tree. This colony has settled into the space between these large rocks since last year. The colony was alive the previous month when Mayu visited. But now, there appear to be dozens of giant hornets coming and going from the entrance of the colony. Giant hornets attack colonies of honeybees and take over. They then proceed to remove all the larvae, pupae, and honey. Giant hornets will aggressively attack anyone who tries to approach the colony they have taken over. The hornets will continue to bring bits of the captured honeybee colony back to their hornet's nest. There is a possibility that the hornets will attack people residing in this area, so Mayu will capture the giant hornets and take a look at what remains of the wild Japanese honeybee colony with an endoscope. This type of glue pad is normally used to capture mice. Mayu will place it near the entrance of the colony to capture the hornets. If hornets turn up while Mayu is checking up on a hive, it's normally not necessary to wear a bee suit for protection, since the hornets are usually just scouting out the area and not aggressive. However, since the hornets that Mayu is addressing today are protecting a food source, Mayu will suit up since there is a chance that they will be aggressive and attack. She also has some hornet repellent as a backup countermeasure. Mayu is placing the glue trap at the entrance. She's already spotted three hornets. The glue trap has already worked on one hornet. A second and third one were shortly captured as well. But the third one managed to get away. After just 5 minutes, 10 giant hornets were captured by the sticky sheets. Giant hornets use pheromones to alert family members to assist them. After the first hornet was captured, the pheromones drew more hornets to the glue sheets. Mayu will leave the sheet here until the evening. As the hours passed, more and more hornets were captured by the glue trap. Mayu also has another beehive nearby this location and will check to see how the bees are doing. This hive is located about 10 meters away from the wild colony that was attacked by giant hornets. Research indicates that Japanese honeybees will smear leaves that they collect at the entrance of the hive to alter the activity or recognition of the hornet's forage site-marking pheromone. Although the colonies are only 10 meters apart, this colony has not been attacked by giant hornets. It could be that the wild colony was the weaker of the two colonies, making it an easier target for the giant hornets. There are a lot of honeybees, and the colony appears to be doing well. It is very unlikely that this colony will be attacked by giant hornets today. Now Mayu is going to investigate the inside of the wild nest with an endoscope to see what remains inside. there doesn't seem to be much activity inside the colony. Pieces of honeycomb are scattered throughout. This is quite a difference from the footage of the colony last year. The comb has been destroyed and there are no larvae or pupae. The giant hornets were removing the honey today. Mayu will close the entrance to prevent more hornets from coming. Thank you for watching today's video. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure to leave them below in the comment section. Please feel free to check out our Instagram, where we post daily about beekeeping in Japan and, of course, Japanese honeybees. We also have a website full of useful information about our native bee. Take care and see you in the next video.